Let's draw the Lewis structure for NO2 minus. This is the nitrite ion. The first thing we do for Lewis structures, we count the total number of valence electrons. It's helpful if we look at the periodic table here. So nitrogen right here, group 15, sometimes called 5A, that has 5 valence electrons. Oxygen, that's in group 16, sometimes called 6A, 6 valence electrons. We have 2 of those oxygen atoms. Plus the negative here, that means we have an extra negative charge. That's an extra valence electron. So we add 1. When we do that, we get 18 total valence electrons for the NO2 minus Lewis structure. We'll put the least electronegative atom in the center of the Lewis structure. That's the nitrogen. So we'll put nitrogen right here, and then we'll put an oxygen atom on either side. Next, we're going to put 2 electrons, a pair of electrons between atoms. That's going to form the chemical bond. So we put 2 between the oxygen and nitrogen. That forms our chemical bond. We form another chemical bond. Now we'll complete the octets for the atoms outside, like this. So far we've used 16 valence electrons. Remember, we have only 18. So we'll go back to complete the octet on that central nitrogen there. But we've run out of valence electrons. Each oxygen, they have 8, but the nitrogen only has 6. So here's what we can do. We can move 2 of these electrons here to form a double bond. So now each oxygen still has 8, but the nitrogen has 2, 4, 6, 8. It has an octet, and we've only used 18 valence electrons. So this is the Lewis structure for NO2 minus, the nitrite ion. Because it's an ion, we should put brackets around it. And then we'll put a negative sign out here. So this is our Lewis structure for NO2 minus. Do note that we have resonance. We could have put the double bond over here instead. Either way is okay, but what happens in reality is this double bond, it's averaged across the ion. So we could draw it like this, showing the bond, that double bond's averaged between the nitrogen and the 2 oxygens. And note, lone pairs aren't shown in this representation. One last thing, the molecular geometry. We have the 2 oxygens. You would think this would be linear, but this lone pair, it's pushing them down. So we end up with what's called a bent molecular geometry. And the bond angle for NO2 minus, that would be 115 degrees. This is Dr. B with the Lewis structure for NO2 minus, the nitrite ion. Thanks for watching.